My first favorite this month. Okay, let me start by saying how hot it has been this few days, and I don't know where winter went or if winter was ever here in Bombay. It's been so hot lately, so sunny lately. So every day that I've been going out, I have not been forgetting to use my sunscreen, and this is the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunblock, and this has an SPF of 50 plus, which is quite high, and which is just the way I like it. I have very oily skin, which is quite prone to acne, and this one is quite light and fresh feeling. You cannot see a white layer on your face like most sunscreens usually tend to give you, that whitish complexion. Leaves your skin feeling very smooth, and it is waterproof and sweatproof. So that is very important for if you're staying in Bombay and there's a lot of humidity, so you tend to sweat a lot, and this has been working out really good with me. So yeah, this is actually my second tube of it. I just finished one tube and this is the second one, and they have also and they have increased the price. I believe it was previously it was 150, now it is for 175, which is okay, I think. Yeah, it's okay, and it is totally worth the price. Yeah. Next up for face is a foundation, and this is an oldie but a goodie. It's the Maybelline Dream Liquid Mousse Foundation, and I wear the color Nude Light. This is the foundation that I reach forward to the most when I want a very nice flawless finish and does not look like I don't want my face to look like I have foundation on, and this color matches me perfectly. I have recently done a blog post talking about most of the foundations that I own, and this one is by far my favorite. It is a mousse, in the bottle it says it gives an airbrush finish, and I think it actually does. It does give a very nice airbrushed effect, and it doesn't even look like you have foundation. It doesn't even look like you're wearing foundation. It blends very easily, and yeah, it's got a little pump which can be locked, so that's really helpful too, and it has a pump, so it's quite sanitary. So yeah, I've been liking this. This is for ₹575, which is pretty good because this will last you really long, and it's only ₹575, which is really nice for a foundation, because most of the good foundations that I know of, most of them are 1000 and above, or I think the Revlon Colorstay one is for around 800. I follow it up with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and this one and the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder is the bomb. I'm telling you, it is the bomb for oily skin. If you have oily skin, I highly recommend this. You should totally check this foundation out. I love it. Another thing from Maybelline that I've been loving this month is the Dream Lumi Touch Highlighting Concealer. So I use this, since it is a highlighting concealer, so I use this mostly under my eyes just to brighten up my face a little bit more, and this is quite nice actually. It brightens up, and it stays quite long, and I've got the color, I don't really know which color I have, I don't know. And doesn't even say, oh, here it is. I have the color Honey Miel. Yeah, but the color honey. Yeah, so I think it's quite nice. I don't actually use the brush. I use my fingers, my ring finger. I don't use the brush. I use my ring finger to gently tap it in and blend it along with my foundation. So I have been loving this. And another thing for face, after using my makeup, I tend to wash my face 2 times, mostly to make sure that my foundation is totally gone. And for my eyes, I'll use a separate makeup remover. But for my face, I was not doing anything special. I was not using. I had the cleansing balm from Clinique, but that got over. So after that, I was not using anything special. Just washing my face twice, and then just using a toner just to remove anything that was left behind. I saw this lying around somewhere in behind all my stuff, and this month I thought, ki, you know, I shouldn't be just letting stuff lay down and you know, just getting spoiled, not being used. So I thought, you know, I'll just use this up and finish it. But I started using this. This is the Oriflame Optimal Cleansing Milk for dry and sensitive skin. This has calming complex with cornflower extract. I just take one pump of this and rub it in between my fingers, and then just dab it across my face in circular motion. Nothing special really. I just do it until I feel that all my makeup is off. And if I'm not feeling lazy, then I'll just use a cotton pad and then spray it with a little water, dampen the cotton pad, and just rub it away from my face. Or if I'm feeling lazy and I don't have time to, you know, take out a cotton pad and wet it and then rub my face, I just go wash my face with a little warm water and then wash it off with my face wash. So this, since it's for dry skin, it is oil based and it is very creamy and rich. So which is why I feel it removes the makeup really well, and it leaves my face feeling really moisturized and hydrated and clean, which is a very rare combination to have, like moisturizing and feeling oily and feeling clean at the same time. I'll move on to some hair products. Actually, I just have one, which was a very difficult decision for me to make, but I made it and I went ahead and got the Moroccan oil for myself. And I'm so happy I made that decision and got the Moroccan oil. It is expensive. I know it is expensive. It's for 2430, and it is in 100 ml bottle. You get 100 ml for 2430, which is a lot if you ask me, but I think this is a holy grail product which every beauty junkie or someone who is someone who likes to take care of their hair and their skin, I think everyone should try this product at least once. And I believe that this is you should look like this, you should think of it as an investment rather than a big buy. I'm just trying to justify it since it being so costly, but yeah, like it is absolutely amazing. I'm telling you, this is so good. My hair never felt softer and never felt more manageable ever since I've been using this. Trust me, this is so good and it smells so good, and you don't need so much, you just need like half a pump. And I have really long hair, which is almost reaching my waist now. So I tend to use this on wet, semi-wet hair, on a damp hair, like 70 to 80% wet hair. 70 to 80% dry hair. On tile dried hair. Just use one pump of this and use it from here and below. Spread it equally and evenly. Use my fingers just to spread it, and then take a wide tooth comb and just spread it so that, and just comb my hair so that it spreads evenly. And my hair feels so nourished, and it feels really smooth actually and manageable. Actually done a whole blog post about this, talking about this. So you should definitely go check it out. And I think you should save up and buy this. It is really nice. I got mine from Jean Cloud The Green Salon at the Palladium Mall. Next, for eye makeup, I have been loving this this eyeshadow trio from Bourjois. This is the Smoky Eye Trio. It's actually quite old and I have been neglecting it for quite some time now, but I am back into loving this and wearing this almost every day. It has three shades, which are something like this. It is a very neutral palette. Let me look at the name. What is it called? I don't think so there is any name for this. I'll link it down below what it's actually called. not sure what's it called. Anyways, this was priced at 645 for 3 eyeshadows, which is good actually. It's okay, it's not bad. And you get 3 eyeshadows which last really long, which are quite very highly pigmented, and they look great even in the morning and night, so you can wear it anytime. This color especially, the darkest one, I freaking love it. It is absolutely beautiful. It is such a beautiful coppery bronze sort of color, which looks very nice on my skin tone, and I think it would suit any Indian olive toned skin. And yeah, it's really nice. It's very nice. I think you should totally check this one out. This is my first ever Bourjois eyeshadow palette, and I'm really impressed. I think I'm gonna check out more of their eyeshadows. I think they're really nice. Next for eyes, I think it'll be a no surprise, this product, because I have talked about this product so much. I'm obsessed with it. I think this product can be a favorite all year long. This is my Maybelline color tattoo in the color Bad to the Bronze, and oh my god, I love this eyeshadow. I just love this eyeshadow so much. I can't even tell how much I love this eyeshadow. It is a simple bronze color. You can use it as a base eyeshadow, just to, like, I usually wear this as a base to this trio. It really brings out the color. It makes the eyeshadow stay even longer than it usually stays, and it just stays all day long. And some people have been telling that they think that the color tattoo dries really quickly, but no, I have not faced anything like that. I have a few more shades in the color tattoo, and all of them are pretty normal. They are creamy, like just the way they were when I initially bought them. This goes well with everything, I'm telling you. Any eyeliner, whether it be green or blue or purple or black or any eyeliner, and you put this as a base and then you put the liner, it just makes you look like as if you put some extra effort in doing your eyes when you just put one layer of this, and it looks really nice. Really brings out your eyes and brings out the color of the liner, which is really nice. Then I have one of my favorite mascaras from Oriflame. I never thought I would like a mascara from Oriflame, because I just ordered it. I haven't tried it or anything. I just ordered it off the catalog, and it is so good. I've actually used it so much, the cap fell off. This is not the actual cap. There is something which is of this color which elongates it a little bit more, but that just fell off. And it is a thing with Oriflame product, like the cap just falls off. I don't know, it's happened with my toner as well. And this one was a Giordani Gold. Oh god, the colors have also come off. I can't even see what it's called. I'll link that down below. Okay, I think I can read it. It's Giordani Gold Extreme Length Mascara. Yes, it's Extreme Length Mascara, and it is so good. Like, it's so good. This is how the wand looks like, and it separates and lengthens your lashes so well. Like, it isn't that expensive also. I think it's $427 or $527, somewhere between the two. Or maybe I got it as, there's always offer going on in Oriflame, so I think I got it at $427, which is amazing. I think I would pay more for this product because it is so good. I would pay around 1,000 rupees for it actually, because it is so good. It is absolutely amazing. I think I like it more than my falsies, and that's saying a lot. I love falsies a lot, but I like this one more than falsies. I have 2 eye pencils. This one is from Lakme and this one is from Chambord. This is from the Lakme Absolute Forever Silk Eyeliner, and this one is the color Jaded Mint, and it is a very beautiful green color, which looks really nice. It's very soft and it's easily super blendable, and it stays put, it's waterproof. So So yeah, I have been liking this. The only problem that I have with it is it's a one-way twist-up, which I don't really like. My phone is ringing. Anyways, I'll get that later. And then I have this one from Shambo. This is their Dazzle Liners. This is transfer-proof smooth eye pencil, and this one is in the color Purple Dazzle. This is also a one-way twist-up pencil, and this is this beautiful dark purple eyeliner. So once you apply this, you have to look really closely to see if it's purple. It's like, I think it's not monochrome, it's like dual chrome color. Like if I turn this side, it looks black, and then if I turn this side, then it looks purple, something that sort. So yeah, it looks absolutely amazing on the upper lash line and on the lower lash line. This is also very smooth, and it is transfer proof, it is waterproof, and does not budge at all. If you follow me on Instagram, you must have already seen this super cute lens case. How cute is this? Just look at him. It's an owl. And it's pink. And it has a nose. How cute is this? I love it. I think I saw these first at someone's video. I think it was Tati's video. Yeah. Tati from Glam Right. I think, yeah, her channel's called Glam Life Guru. And she does daily videos. Yeah, she does super amazing videos actually. And I saw this in one of her videos, and I thought to myself that I need it in my life. And I was looking for it. I couldn't find it, and I almost forgot about it. And then I was just on Facebook one day, and then there was this ad just popped up. And I, this picture was on it, and I was like, oh my god, I need that. And I just clicked it and I bought it. I got it from Prop Shop 24. I am going to put a link down below so you guys can go check it if you wear contact lens. And the last thing that I have is it's a nail polish. Unfortunately, I'm not wearing this today, or else I would love to show this to you. This is the Sally Hansen Hardest Nails Extreme Wear Color. Nail color. Yeah, this is in the color Golden Eye, number 485. This is the most beautiful golden shade that I have ever seen in my life. I have been wearing this so much in February. So much. I can't even tell you how many times I've worn this. I think I've worn it more than 3 times actually, and this lasts really long, lasts around 4 to 5 days. I think nail paints on me chip really quickly. I don't know, I don't do that much stuff. I don't wash dishes that often, or I don't wash my hands that often, but I don't know, nail polishes can chip really quickly on my nails, but this one doesn't. And I have very brittle nails, like, and they tend to break off right in the near the nail bed, and it really hurts. Like your nail can be this long and then it just breaks off right in the nail bed, and not just on the edge, like way above somewhere here, so something like this, see. So I it looks like as if my entire nail is off, and it really hurts. Anyways, so this one is the only nail polish which has actually hardened my nails. I can actually sometimes when my nails are long and if you bend it, my nails can actually bend, but when I'm wearing this, my nails don't bend. I know that's TMI, but yeah, this one makes my nails really hard and strong. The nail polish stays on for quite long, and this is a very pretty glittery golden color which I really love. So that's all that I have for my monthly favorites. Thank you so much for watching, and now it's time to find out the giveaway winners for last month's giveaway. First of all, Thank you so much to everyone who commented. Thank you, Magali, for commenting. You were the first person to comment, and I'm so grateful to everyone else who commented. My friend Karishma, thank you so much for commenting. And yeah, it was really, this is the first time that I was giving away something, and I was really happy, and that was something that I really wanted to do, and give away something that I have been loving. And I also want you guys to try it and see that why I like it so much, and to see if you feel the same way. And yeah, so now I thought I'll do it by random.org, but I was finding it a little difficult to figure out how it works. So I'm just going to do it the old way out, and I'm just going to write all the names down. There are only 12 names, and I'm going to write all of them down in a piece of paper and fold them up and then put it in a bowl and put it in a bowl and then shuffle them all, and then I'm going to ask someone to pick it up, and whosoever names comes up, that'll be the winner. So it's time for me to pick up the giveaway winners. I have written down all the names in a chit, and I wanted it to be really fair. So I'm asking my brother to pick it up for me. He just got back home from work, so I was waiting for him to come. And so yeah, let's pick up one chit out of, oops, one fell off. You can select, okay. Okay, so this is the time we pick up the winner, and the winner is